Hello, this is Matt on the Moon Lambo channel. It is Christmas in August. And you know what I have to say about that? Merry Christmas, damn it. Here's the headline from Cointelegraph. Crypto mom Hester Peirce slams SEC for $10 million Poloniex settlement. And you may recall, within the last few weeks or so, two of five commissioners within the SEC, Hester Peirce and Elad Roisman, they wrote something which is publicly listed on the official SEC website, and they acknowledge that the SEC has never, and currently is not, offered regulatory clarity in the crypto space. And Ripple, their attorneys, because mind you, the SEC is coming after them, their attorneys saw this and quickly followed court documents indicating, hey, look right here, even the SEC, at least some at the SEC in high positions, mind you, say the same thing that we're arguing, which is that we didn't have fair notice, which is a legal argument, by the way, an important legal argument with teeth. We didn't have fair notice that what we were doing would have been perceived as illegal by the SEC. Now, that was a gift. That was a serious gift. And Ripple capitalized on that, rightfully so, of course, because they did not receive fair notice. You know, an unbiased person, anybody that's unbiased, just almost 100% of humans I've seen that write about this topic, unbiased people say Ripple's in the right, the SEC being a bunch of asshats, effectively. That's what I keep hearing. Asshat this, asshat that. That's how they behave, you know? Bunch of asshats marching along. Asshats, SEC. That's what they sound like, just marching along being asshats. And so we got another gift. That's why it's Christmas in August. And so because Hester Peirce, upon this settlement here, she stated yet again that there is not sufficient regulatory clarity. And you are going to love this. Wait till you hear some of these specifics. And then attorney John Deaton, who is the attorney seeking to intervene in the SEC versus Ripple case on behalf of about 19,000 XRP holders, he chimed in and rightfully blames Gary Gensler, the current SEC chair, for regulating by enforcement. Now, look, I don't have a legal or financial background of any kind. I am not offering legal or financial advice, and you should not buy or sell anything because of anything that I say or write. That would be a not so hot idea. I'm just an enthusiast that likes to make YouTube videos all up on the internets, but purely as a fun hobby. That's all that's going on here. And so here was the headline from yesterday from CoinDesk. Poloniex agrees to $10 million settlement with SEC for operating unregistered exchange. Former Circle subsidiary Poloniex has agreed to pay $10.4 million settlement charges with the U.S. Securities and Exchange Commission for operating an unregistered digital asset exchange. The SEC found that Poloniex's trading platform facilitated the buying and selling of digital assets, some of which were investment contracts and therefore classified as securities, according to an announcement Monday. Poloniex has agreed to pay a disgorgement of approximately $8.5 million, prejudgment interest of $400,000, and a civil penalty of $1.5 million, coming to $10.4 million in total. And so, my friends, this is why I've been saying for the longest damn time, like, I understand why some people are within our community are upset that there are a number of exchanges that halted or delisted XRP. I'm much more sympathetic because, like, these exchanges are businesses, you know, and there are people there. And they have careers there, and they're supporting their families with their income from these exchanges, and they've got to protect themselves. They've got to protect the management's got to protect their employees so that they can protect their families. And so I'm really nothing but sympathetic to the exchanges that felt like the prudent thing to do was to, at least for now, halt the trading of XRP. It's not their fault. It's the SEC's fault. And here you go, right here. This is exactly why I don't blame them one bit. They went after Poloniex. Who's to say that the SEC won't come after other exchanges that already have offered the XRP on their platforms, even if they ultimately ended up halting? Like, let's see how this thing pans out. I mean, obviously, that's not going to happen if this court case goes in favor of Ripple and XRP. But if it doesn't, they're in trouble. Like, seriously, they're going to be sweating bullets here. And so then there's this headline from today. Crypto mom Hester Peirce slams SEC for $10 million Poloniex settlement. Then this is absolutely rich. This is a gift to Ripple And you know Ripple's legal team will be filing court documents. They're going to be adding this, and it will be more evidence for their fair notice defense. And so I'm assuming that Hester Peirce, among some, especially the legal team over at the SEC, they're probably not a fan of Hester. I'm guessing that she's not allowed to sit at their lunch table, right? I'm going to guess that that's it. It's very clicky at the SEC, I'm guessing here, right? But I am a huge fan of Hester, and what she's doing, it takes guts, you know? She should feel very proud of what she's doing. She feels strongly about it, and she's not acquiescing. She's not piping down. She's speaking truth. This is to be applauded. Anyway, the piece reads as follows. United States Securities and Exchange Commission Commissioner Hester Peirce, known colloquially as Crypto Mom, which is a weird name, but anyway, she's embraced it, though. It's fine. She has slammed the SEC for its $10 million settlement with cryptocurrency exchange Poloniex. The SEC announced the $10 million settlement on Monday, with Poloniex being charged with facilitating trades in unregistered securities between July 2017 and November 2019. The SEC asserted that Poloniex employees, quote, stated internally, end quote, that they wanted to be aggressive in circumventing securities regulation in a bid to increase market share by listing new digital assets that may be deemed securities under the Howey test of 1946. Poloniex elected to neither admit nor deny any wrongdoing. On the same day, Peirce slammed the regulators' actions in a public statement, emphasizing the opaque regulatory framework that crypto firms must navigate in the United States. The commissioner highlighted several regulatory matters that the SEC has been criticized for failing to clarify with regards to digital asset businesses, including how to determine whether an asset is a security and what licenses and exemptions are appropriately required to operate a cryptocurrency exchange. Take a look at this quote. Given how slow we have been in determining how regulated entities can interact with crypto, market participants may understandably be surprised to see us come onto the scene now with our enforcement guns blazing and argue that Poloniex was not registered or operating under an exemption as it should have been, end quote. Guys, see, this is to be respected. I read that and I was just like, yes, jaw dropped on the floor. Absolutely. Keep it coming, Hester. Peirce added, if Poloniex had tried to register it as a securities exchange or as an alternative trading system with the SEC, the firm, quote, likely would have waited and waited and waited some more, end quote. Exactly. And I read this piece. This is the full thing. I didn't want to go through this whole piece that she wrote up for this video. It's not necessary to get all the points across, but the first time I read that, I was sitting there like, yes, this is true. So here's somebody, one of the most high up individuals working at the SEC, acknowledging that even if Poloniex had approached the SEC, and because they don't know if they have to comply in certain ways and get, you know, certain certifications, this or that, even if they had gone that route out of an extreme abundance of caution, they wouldn't have been able to conduct their business. Because the SEC doesn't know how they want to proceed. They're not providing regulatory clarity. And again, so this is not just an SEC versus Ripple thing. This is a huge problem for the entire crypto space, which is why the community needs to stay united. I mean, look, there's not enough unitedness within the space as far as I'm concerned on this front. Until we see Bitcoin Maxi saying that Ripple should not be sued by the SEC, like there's not sufficient unity in my mind. But I mean, there are all sorts of people that have kind of come together. Just I'd like to see more on that front, because even if you're cheering because you don't like Ripple and don't like XRP and you're cheering this has happened, like you're next. You are next. And if you don't think you are, you're wrong in all likelihood. And so here is the tweet when Hester first shared what she wrote there, which is on the SEC website now. She wrote this on Twitter. Thoughts on Poloniex action, which reflects our continued enforce don't figure out how to reasonably regulate approach. That's beyond a golf clap. That's a real clap right there up in this bitch. Somebody named John responded and wrote, which securities were they selling? ? And Hester responded to that as well and wrote, that's part of the problem. When we announce these cases, we won't say which digital assets were securities. See Commissioner Roizman's and my comments here. And then she points to that initial publication from a few weeks ago where I already covered in reference earlier. And so here, you have Poloniex paying a fine And the SEC's not saying specifically which assets they sold that they should not have sold so that the market would have clarity. They want confusion in the space. They want to be able to have all things and argue whatever the hell they want, whatever suits them at the time. And they don't want to restrict themselves by providing regulatory clarity. They just don't. These are not good. The people in charge of this that refuse to provide the clarity, they're not good people. They're wrecking people's lives. And these are businesses, again, that support their families. Like, can you imagine the stress that you have to go through if you're one of these entities getting unrightfully attacked and you're just trying to have an honest living, and then you're getting harmed and you got kids? Like, the amount of stress that these people must be feeling, I'm sympathetic. This is not right. This is not justice. And so then attorney John Deaton retweeted what Hester Peirce wrote there. And he wrote the following. And the first part was just a quote from Hester. Today's enforcement action against Poloniex, once a popular crypto trading platform in the United States, doubles down on the commission's enforcement-centric approach to crypto, end quote. And then he takes Hester Peirce and writes, Hester says it like it is, says it like it is. And then he takes Gary Gensler, SEC chair. He's the guy running the whole show here. And says, Gary, why are you engaging in regulation by enforcement? Because reasons. It seems to me, it really does just look like a power grab. It's like, he's doing what Jay Clayton was doing, but on steroids. Like, he's doing even more of that. He's doubling and tripling down on all these policies that just don't work. It's I'm disgusted by all of it, but it is what it is. So at least we're cognizant of this and we're paying attention to it, and people are fighting back. So just spread the word. I think there's reason to remain optimistic, but unfortunately we don't know for sure all this is going to pan out. It's an interesting ride, to say the least. But I'll go ahead and wrap up here. I'm not a financial advisor. You should not buy or sell anything because of anything I say or write. That would be a very, very, very bad idea. Until next time, to the moon, Lambeau.